Hey Deckers, ever wanted a bigger screen for your Steam Deck, or all of the other screens are taken and you want something a bit bigger than just your deck screen? Well, we may have the device for you, it's something to fill the void of a laptop. However, this does come at a cost, and quite a hefty one at that, at $340. So it looks like a laptop, but it's not a laptop. It's something called a Lapdock, and it has the USB-C, it has a micro USB port, the USB-C out, as well as a mini HDMI. Size-wise, this is a 13.3-inch, and it is a little bit bigger than the iPad 9th generation, and it pretty much weighs about the same as well. So if you are looking for a comparison, there is a bit of a difference here. So let's dive in. Uperfect Lapdock here, thanks for sending this over. It is an awesome little device. One thing that caught me out is that the power button is on the side, not on the front, as you would expect. This is touchscreen as well, and you just swipe down to get to the menu here. It has some nice little controls of being able to switch power mode on and off, so whether you have pass-through charging, or whether you have the USB-C as the input, or the mini HDMI. Touchscreen is very responsive, and it is very good. You'll have to excuse my crude setup here. This does fold completely flat if you want it as a flat screen, or you can prop it up, have it as a freestanding monitor as well. Touchscreen is absolutely fantastic on this, so let's get it set up against the Steam Deck and get into the good stuff. Can connect this straight through with just a single USB-C cable, and the Steam Deck will pick it up as a dock as normal with the touchscreen. However, you may have guessed that the pass-through power is not powerful enough for the Steam Deck, so you will get the slow charger warning. Let's have a chat about that battery life. In my testing, with the pass-through power enabled, the Steam Deck lost around 55% in an hour of playing Spider-Man Remastered, and the screen itself lost around 22% battery. So quite a bit of a drop on both of them, although the display is still going to outlast the Steam Deck. However, with the pass-through power turned off, the screen only lost around 17% power, so we're looking at around 4 to 5 hours battery life on the screen, and this Steam Deck 60% of its power. So the screen is definitely going to outlast the Steam Deck in either scenario. Now the problem with this is that because it is a single USB-C and the power is not enough to charge the deck, charging up the screen at the same time is not going to save you any power on the Steam Deck, which is a little bit annoying, and we'll cover some of the options that you have for charging the Steam Deck and using this dock in just a minute. So let's first dive into desktop mode, and this is where this dock really shines. If you're going to be spending quite a lot of time in desktop mode on the Steam Deck, then this is a fantastic addition. Takes all that pain of not having the mouse and keyboard properly on the Steam Deck, and still gives you the versatility of needing a touchscreen as well if you wanted. The keyboard is very nice to type on. The mouse, well, I'm not a big fan of trackpads in general, especially on laptops. However, I would prefer it to be a little bit more sensitive on the clicks than I have used in other devices. When it comes to game mode, again, it works perfectly fine, but you really will have to fiddle with the sensitivity of the trackpad to get it just right, and I find it a little bit awkward trying to use the trackpad keyboard to play games here. Like you would on any laptop, this is not the greatest way to be playing. And this is where one of the problems comes in for me. I would love to be able to just use this and plug in a physical mouse. However, that's where the problem lies, as there is no USB input. This means that you will not be able to plug in an external mouse and use it on the Steam Deck with this plugged in, unless you use something like a dock. However, if you do use a third-party controller, like an Xbox Series X controller, for example, paired up with your Steam Deck, then this is a non-issue, and now you can play to your heart's content. No input latency at all. It was absolutely perfect playing this, and actually being able to sit back a little bit with a bigger screen really was a fantastic way to play this if you are looking to play with a separate controller. Now to excuse the screen, the colours are actually extremely good, just as good as the Steam Deck itself. However, my camera recording setup is not the best, and it just seems to concentrate on giving better colour to my desk than it does for the screen. And when we put it into the full screen mode, You'll see that it takes a minute for it to flip over. However, it does look absolutely fantastic in the freestanding screen mode. Again, it's just going to be the battery on your Steam Deck that's going to be the issue in the long run. So recently, I reviewed something called a 3-in-1 power charger from JSOX, and I thought with the USB cable on this, so as we got the HDMI, we have to obviously go through the USB-C here and use a mini HDMI. However, because we are now going through the dock and the screen is plugged in via the HDMI, we lose both the touchscreen and the keyboard control. So again, you would have to be looking at using a controller, but now you are able to power the Steam Deck and use the screen, which means that you will be able to get much longer battery life. So that will get you around 4 to 5 hours battery. However, if you use something like a full dock, then you will be able to have the USB-C pass through. You'll be able to have the extra USB for your mouse, HDMI to micro HDMI for your picture, and now you'll be able to charge your Steam Deck and have a mouse and keyboard as well. However, as you can see, that's a lot of stuff plugged in, and it's not the most graceful solution. If you don't have your own TV though, then this will give you a lot more flexibility, but just at quite a hefty cost. Overall though, this is a fantastic device, but it is only going to fit very specific use cases. If you are after one of these, or you have a good use case for this, then check out the link in the description below so you can pick one of these up. It is an affiliate link, so I will get a bit of a commission for that if you use that link, so much appreciated. I don't have a particular use for this screen moving forwards though, although I'm extremely grateful for the opportunity to give this one a review. And I really hope that they give the opportunity to have a pass-through 45 watt version in the near future to negate that charging issue. If you have a use case for this, let us know in the comments below, and I will be giving this away to a lucky commenter over the next week or so. Keep an eye on our socials for many other giveaways, and if we get any further news on a more powerful charging version of this laptop. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.